In this video, I'm going to teach you how to set up a local development environment for Kubernetes using Minikube. Setting up an actual Kubernetes cluster yourself is a very long and painful process. If you're aiming to be a Kubernetes administrator, then it is an exercise I highly recommend you do. But while you're just starting out, it is better to first learn how to use Kubernetes properly. So right now, setting up a Kubernetes cluster is not the best use of your time. The main goal for now is to get a cluster up and running quickly so that we can learn to deploy our applications onto it. Minikube is a developer tool that makes setting up an entire Kubernetes cluster on your PC as simple as running a single terminal command. So I'm going to show you how to set up Minikube on your personal computer, how to create a Kubernetes cluster using it, and finally we're going to play around with that cluster because what else are we going to do with it? Welcome to the third chapter of Kubernetes from Zero to Hero. My name is Raghav. Let's get started. Before we begin, make sure you have a broad understanding of Kubernetes architecture and its main components. And if you don't, of course I have a video for it. It is true that Minikube makes it dead simple for you to run Kubernetes, but this thing is not meant for production use. If you use Minikube in prod, the Kubernetes police will come for you. It is a tool purely for personal development environments. The good thing is Minikube supports all major operating systems and CPU architectures. So chances are that it'll run nicely on your computer. But you can get the very best experience if you're running a Linux machine because Linux has native container support, so no extra virtual machine hassle. Now, you should already have Docker installed on your system. Also, make sure your computer has at least a decent configuration in terms of disk storage, CPU, memory, and that you have an internet connection. Okay, I'm going to install Minikube on my Mac, but you can find instructions for other platforms in the documentation.
All links are mentioned in the description below.
So to install Minikube, we as engineers need to do what we do best. And now we can just start the cluster. It works. With a single command, I have a Kubernetes cluster running on my computer. Now, before we start playing around, you need to have a basic idea of what Minikube is doing in the background. When you run a new Kubernetes cluster, Minikube creates a virtual environment for it to run inside. This means it usually starts a new virtual machine or a Docker container on your PC. By default, it starts a new Docker container, if Docker is installed on your system, of course. This container is created from KIC base, which is a Docker image developed by Minikube. It comes packed with all the Kubernetes processes like the API server, scheduler, kubelet, and so on. The container acts as the server running your entire Kubernetes cluster, which means both the control plane and the worker node processes. When you deploy a pod, it is scheduled on a worker node. Since this container also acts as the worker node, the pod also runs inside it. But of course, I can launch more worker nodes on my computer. Then my pods will be scheduled on those nodes and this container will only be running the control plane components. Okay, I want to go inside this container to show you the internals of my cluster. Let's use exec to go inside the main container. Now this is the Minikube server. Minikube runs all the Kubernetes processes as pods. So when I run Docker PS, you can actually see all the processes, even the control plane ones, running as Docker containers here. So yes, this is literally containers running inside a container. Don't be confused about it. Awesome. Now that you understand how Minikube deploys a cluster on your PC, let's start playing with Kubernetes. The Minikube CLI gives you everything you need. I can easily get the status of the control plane components of my cluster. So if I stop my cluster and run status again, I can see the values have been updated. And I can see the status changes when I pause and unpause my cluster as well. The stop command stops the Kubernetes cluster and shuts down the Minikube container. But the pause command only stops the cluster and doesn't shut down the Minikube container itself. Now, one of the coolest things is that Minikube also lets you fire up the Kubernetes dashboard UI. There's a whole bunch of things here. Don't worry about all this terminology. You will learn them in the coming videos. For now, I want to show you pods. Here, I can see all the pods I'm running in my cluster. And currently, there are none. But in the next chapter, we'll also launch a pod and this area will be more populated. I also want to show you nodes. This lists all the nodes running in my cluster. As you can see, right now there's just one, which is the container itself. It has all the resources of my computer. These are the pods that Minikube ran just to run the cluster itself. This dashboard is the most useful utility as it gives you the entire picture of your Kubernetes cluster. There's one more very important command that can help you troubleshoot when things go sideways, and that is the logs command. Minikube can display logs from my cluster. By default, I get the control plane logs, but I can also specify a node to get only that node's logs. Another useful option is problems. This will only produce logs which point to known issues within the cluster or the nodes. Minikube also has a concept of drivers. By default, Minikube runs the Kubernetes cluster inside a Docker container. But you can also ask it to run the Kubernetes cluster inside a virtual machine, like KVM or VirtualBox, by using the right driver. So drivers provide the flexibility in terms of what platform you want to run your Kubernetes cluster on. But the default Docker driver is pretty convenient in my opinion. And that's it. Thanks to Minikube, I have a Kubernetes cluster running on my local machine in less than 5 minutes. I'm now ready to deploy my applications. And in the next chapter, that is exactly what we are going to do. We're going to deploy a Hello World application in our Kubernetes cluster. Your assignment for today is to figure out how to run a Minikube cluster on your PC with 3 worker nodes. Comment below and tell me how you would achieve this. If you enjoy learning with me, subscribe now. Press a like and share this video with your friends. Your support makes all the difference for me. See you in the next video.